Hello friends, myself Harpreet Kaur Saini. Welcome to Anthropology and Tutorial. Today we will discuss about the anthropology of religion, right? In this video, we will discuss about some definitions which are given by different anthropologists. Definition and function of religion, right? So there's number of religious definitions which are given by different anthropologists. So we will discuss in this video. And after that, we will discuss about the religious functionaries like priests, witchcraft, sorcerers, medicine man, and shamans. So these are the some religious functionaries, right? So we will discuss about these, and after that, in last, we will discuss about the totem and taboos, right? So let's start. So the very first definition, which is given by E.B. Tyler, right? So first of all, the anthropologist speak in term of universal institutions found in all societies. There are that institutions are kinship, economy, politics, and religion. So these are the main institutions which are studied by the anthropologist, right? So E.B. Tyler in his book Primitive Culture, which is given in 1871, he explained the definition of religion, that is defined as belief in the spiritual being. So E.B. Tyler said that belief or a faith in the spiritual being is a definition of religion. But Robson Smith, who studied sacrifice in different part of the world, so he said that this definition, E.B. Tyler's definition, is incomplete, partial, and he is only include the element of faith or a belief and does not take care of the fact that religion is also a matter of practice, because there are some people who practice some rituals. So he gave, then after that Robson Smith gave the definition that practice of beliefs and rituals is called a religion. There is a close relationship between belief and rituals and should be studied as a whole. So this is the main definition. So Robson Smith criticized E.B. Tyler's definition because E.B. Tyler gave this definition about a belief or a faith in a spiritual being. So this is an incomplete definition according to the Robson Smith, right? Then after that, there are other scientists, anthropologists who give the definition of religion, but here I am just talking about a Durkheim. Right, Durkheim would provided one of the most acceptable definition of religion in his book Elementary Form of Religious Life. Right, he argued that conclusion should be drawn only after the study on a religious institution that is necessary, which the religion deal with the supernatural power. Right, then after that Durkheim explained that all the human societies conceptualize the entire universe divided into things, objects, ideas, beliefs, practices, and entities which are set apart are forbidden and termed as sacred entities, right? Which are given by the Durkheim. So Durkheim gave the very influential definition that is, religion is a unifying set of beliefs which are included the function of uniform set of beliefs and practices, meaning thereby that every belief find its manifestation in practice. Belief and practice pertain to sacred entities, right? Because every religion has their sacred entities, right? There are rules separated the sacred from the profane. People follow two sacred things. By doing so, they are bound in a moral community called church. And the unity of beliefs and practices, association of religions with sacred entities, and social solidarity are some ideas that are derived from the Durkheim concept. Right? So he explained that what is sacred? Sacredness is an attitude which is imposed by people on objects. So this is a sacred object. Because every culture or every community have, or every religious have their own sacred places, right? Sacred things to which he practice or believe in that, right? So sacredness is an attitude which imposes people on objects. So he explained according to the rituals, beliefs in a spiritual being, and practice some rituals according to their sacred things, right? So he explained in this way. So this is the concept of Durkheim, right? After that, A.R. Radcliffe Brown broadly accepted the Durkheim's analysis, but he gave priority to rituals because they are collectively performed. Because rituals are largely invariant, then beliefs are variant considerably, that every belief could be a representation of individual thought, because belief is an individual thought. Unlike belief, ritual can be observed and beliefs are thought out patterns. So Radcliffe Brown said that religion can be defined as concerned with sacred entities like Durkheim. He also found that function of religion was creative solidarity, social solidarity, because we know that because he is a structural anthropologist, right? So he gave gave definition according to that, right? Then after that, Durkheim, another definition which is very influential interpretation of functional point of view, he argued that social life is impossible without moral values. Then moral values comprise the collective consciousness. So religion reinforces the collective consciousness, strengthens the unity of a group, and promotes social solidarity. So again, he explained according to the social solidarity, but his concept is applicable in simple societies where one type of people that exist who have a belief in a one type of religion, right? But then after that, it is not applicable in the complex societies, right? Then after that, there's another anthropologist, Malinowski, who gave the definition that notes that situation of life crisis promote anxiety, tension, such situations are associated with religious rituals. His main argument that religions promote social solidarity by dealing with the situation to emotional stress, which threaten the stability of society. So he explained according to the functional concept, and he take care of the psychological aspect of religion, right? Then after that, Radcliffe Brown, and both Malinowski and Radcliffe Brown has been criticized by a different anthropologist, because Malinowski was mainly emphasized on a psychological function, and whereas Radcliffe Brown has been criticized for his over-emphasize on social function and not giving any consideration to other function, because Malinowski gave more emphasis on the psychological aspect, right? But he ignored the educational, procreation and sociological and other functions, right? So that's why Malinowski and Radcliffe Brown has been criticized by different anthropologists. Right after that, religious functionaries. So there are some religious functionaries like priests. So first we will discuss about priests, after that shamans, then sorcerers, then medicine men, then sorcerers, then witchcraft, right? So very first is religion, priest. So who are the priests? What are the function of priests, right? So we will discuss about that. Priests are the religious specialists associated with organized churches and are chiefly found in more formally structured societies or a complex societies throughout the globe. And there are some simple societies also where priests are found, right? So they receive extensive training at the conclusion of which they are obtained or legitimized in their offices through formal ceremonies. Priesthood is a manifestation of developed religion, but it can also found in a relatively ordered and primitive societies where cultures are rich and complex. They enjoy a very high status in the community, and inhabitants respect them as they possess the power to reach the god and goddess. Right? The priests perform life cycle rituals and his position is hereditary. They have to learn some training because other priests give extensive training to them so that they hire this priest position. Right? They receive extensive training at the conclusion of which they are ordained and legitimized in their offices through formal ceremonies. Right? So after that, knowledge is learned and rituals are memorized. In every occasion, priests are invited so that they can practice their according to their ritual and pray to God according to their rituals, right? So in the religious system that they have a priest, these leaders serve as a mediator between the people and the supernatural entity. Often they are more concerned with general welfare of the community rather than of the problem of the individual, because they serve for whole community. They pray for whole community. They because they have enough knowledge about how to solve the problem of the community, how to solve the problem of a particular individual who comes to them and asks a solution from priest, and priest they have enough knowledge about their religion so that they give them a good idea or good thought or good prescription according to which they can individual or a community can solve their problem, and they have enough power that how to pray to God and how God can fulfill their wishes. So they have enough knowledge about that because they receive some extensive training, so that people call them a mediator because they pray to God as a mediator, because individual come to them and told them to pray for this purpose or this purpose. So these have enough power to pray to God so that God can fulfill their wishes, right? So this is about a priest. After that, shamans. Who are the shamans? Shamans are a religious specialist whose primary function is healing the sick and protecting the community from harm. The shamans are classed as a religious practitioner because their healing proceeds by supernatural intervention. Societies with subsistence economics show the presence of shamans. Such societies tend to form with nomadic or a semi-nomadic food collectors. These are mostly found in the simple societies. They are not found in the complex or civilized society. Mostly these are found in the past, right? But is there some now in present time there are some tribals exist in which they are found, right? They found in the Amazon area. Such societies tend to form with nomadic or semi-nomadic or food collectors. These are the some tribal societies in which they are found, right? He hold a very high status in his community. Inhabitants often call him to cure the diseases. Shamans know sacred songs, pantomimes and other specialized formulas to serve the community, because they sung some sacred songs through which they heal the person, right? So they have their own techniques through which they heal the person, right? Then a shaman's position is not hereditary. He is acquired power and virtue of being chosen by divine, right? So divine choose them, right, and give some extensive training to them because they have some great mission, so that they can serve to the community. They do everything for welfare of the community, right, or welfare of the person who is sick. So he cure according to that, right? Then the entire knowledge is dependent upon the shaman because of the mere fact that he has been selected for a purpose. Shamanic action is involuntary because shaman have to carry out the ritual as divine power want, right? So in Amazon forest they are still living and have enough knowledge about the medicinal plants which improve the psychic ability and give them power to watch and visualize to see the past and future events. If a people come to them and ask him who commit the crime or kill that person, then they can easily tell them about the person with their vision, because God bless this type of vision to them, and because shamans are chosen by a God, because God gives some great purpose to them so that they serve to the community. So they have enough power to see the past and future, right? So because God gives them enough power to sense and see vision of the past and future, they can leave soul from their body and talk with the spirit or go to the spirit world and again enter to their own body, right? According to that, they heal to the person. And the preparatory stage of shamanic inspiration is painful and lengthy. First they have to do things to gain that power, right? Then after that they take that power and which are given by the divine, and divine choose them. They do not only undergo head training by the older shamans, right? Because they are not taking any training from the shamans. They have to do things to gain a power, but God tell them to take this type of power because those people are chosen by the God, and God tell them to do these things so that you can take this power, right? Then they remain far apart from care and distraction for ordinary life. At this time, they experience the supernatural being and the other world. The spirit talks with them and instructs many magical formula. Thus, they acquire great power to summon a storm, to vanish a game, or to cure a patient. Two kinds of shamans are found: emotional shamans and the steady shamans. The emotional shamans are usually unstable, even an epileptic. During the performance of rites, their physical features get distorted. Muscles are convulsed and eyes are strained. And shamans at this stage may roll on the ground, bring a form at the mouth. And another is steady shamans, on the other hand, are not prone to emotional or epileptic fit. For guidance, they depend on the guardian spirit that come to them in a dream, right? So these are the two type of shamans, right? So this is all about shamans, and these are found in the food gathering nomadic or semi-nomadic societies, right? But there are some tribal societies where they are still exist, and they have enough power and they have enough knowledge about the medicinal plant which they use for these purposes, right, to gain that type of power. Then after that, medicine man. So medicine man is used for individual who is mainly concerned with the local medicine system. Medicine man prepare various kind of medicine and may also be a local surgeon or a bone settler. Medicine man may not perform any kind of ritual or may entirely rely upon techniques, because they know some type of techniques through which they cure the person, right, or heal the person. So natives of simple societies are a magico-religious. A medicine man also combine religious ritual with his primitive techniques, and medicine man also have a knowledge of medicinal plants which used for curing or healing purposes, right? So people specially hire to the medicine man so they can cure the person according to their diseases, and they have enough knowledge about the medicinal plants which they are used for the curing purposes, and they are completely secular. They may not perform any kind of ritual, may entire upon. They only have the special techniques through which they heal the person, and consider that worldview of a people in a simple society because they believe in a magical religious. So they hire these medicine men, and they are like a doctor, because these medicine men are like a well, right? So in complex society we call them doctor, but these are the medicine men who know about the plants, right? Who know about the medicinal plants which are used for different purposes, or for curing diseases, or for curing any illness which are either a chronic or a permanent, right? So they have enough knowledge about that. So they according to use that, and they have also knowledge of some charms, right? So some mantras, so which they use for curing purposes, because they know some type of magic also. And then these medicine men use their own technique to cure the diseases, and right? So I've already explained you about that. So these medicine men are found in the simple societies, right? So again, now next is sorcerers, right? Then they are religious specialists who can cause a harm or a kill enemy. They also serve a community interest, since they eliminate the evil that are found in the societies, right? Then sorcerers are found in the society with varying economic basis. They may receive their calling and skills in a vision. They may not also be a recognized powerful individual by member of their society, because they do both type of magic, either a black magic or a white magic. They have knowledge about these things, and their position is not hereditary. They have to take training from the old sorcerers so that they know the technique to do some black magic and a white magic, right? So sorcerers are found in society with varying economic basis, right? It is not compulsory that it is only found in the simple society. It is also found in some civilized societies also, right? So shamans believe in the key of effective of sorcerers. So Levi-Strauss distinguished three area of belief. The sorcerer's belief in his or her technique, the victims believe in the sorcerer's power, and the communities believe in the power of sorcery, right? but the practitioner may be held as accountable if the countermeasure taken to work or sorcerers may be accused of practicing narrative magic or could be thought of a lost power, right? Various kind of religious leaderships are not necessarily vested in a separate individual. These categories are often destructive of function than of individuals. There are often an overlap in a function, especially between priests and shamans and between shamans and sorcerers. In given society, the distinction between function may not be prominent, or the individual religious specialist may have a multiple role. Right? So sorcery denotes evil magic or magic that seek to benefit the practitioner or his client. In most of the primitive societies, such act is not socially approved and so treated as a crime against society. And it involves the use of some material, object, medicines for evoking supernatural power to harm people. Sorcerers use some material like a bone, skulls to do sorcery, or even use some chart, candle or other material, dolls and chemicals through which they hypnotize the person and do all the events according to them. Right? Sorcerers can also do these two types of magic, like a black or white magic. You can see in the movies that they use a doll through which they hypnotize the person. So that is all a sorcery, right? So it's all about a sorcery. Then after that, witchcraft. The term witchcraft is derived from a Judeo-Christian, right? Tradition. Devil is a source of witchcraft power. The devil conducts activity either by entering the body or by signing pact with the human being. By witchcraft, anthropologists means a belief in a mystical power that develop in some societies, enable them to work evil directly without magic or spiritual assistance. Right? Then there's some tribe where it is these types of beliefs are exist. Azan. Ivan Pritchard made distinction between sorcery and witchcraft. Sorcery is learned where the power of witchcraft is acquired from birth, not demonstrable. Performance of ritual being about desired ritual in sorcery. But in witchcraft, evil is transferred through the eyes. Sorcery seems a universal, but witchcraft seems a characteristics of stable society with a complex social grouping as notably absent among the hunter-gatherers. Right? It is existing everywhere, either in social simple societies or in a civilized societies. Right? Then there are a number of anthropologists who study about the witchcraft. Right? Before witchcraft study, the study of Azan, witchcraft was viewed as a pathological condition and anomaly of the society. Among the Azans, the entire society has firm belief in witchcraft. All conflicts are explained in the term of witchcraft accusation. They believe on the witchcraft. In fact, witchcraft becomes the natural philosophy of the people and form the explanation system of the people. Right? So there are a number of tribal societies, the Noob, Gwari, Korongo or Mesakins, revealed that belief in witchcraft is more prominent among Noob, where conflict between husband and wife are explained in the term of witchcraft. Among Mesakin, where society is marked by rigid age grade system, social mobility is less pronounced, which is breed hostility or antagonism. So they believe that if any confliction is existing between the husband and wife, this is because of the witchcraft. So witchcraft has not disappeared, rather there has been revival of the same in the Western world called modern witchcraft or a white witchcraft, right? So this is all about witchcraft. So now we will discuss about the sorcery. Most commonly, sorcery denotes evil magic or magic that seek to benefit the practitioner or a client in a way that drive others. Some anthropologists apply the situation in which spiritual assistance is evoked. So sorcery is considered dangerous and antisocial, right? So I already explained about that. But there are some sorcery who is for beneficial for the person who go to the sorcerers, right? So they do sorcery for themselves also, right? So this is all about the functioners, religious functioners. Then after that, totemism. What is a totem? The term totem is taken from the South American context. Totemism is a system of belief in which man is believed to have a kinship tie with a totem, or a mystical relationship is said to be exist between a group or an individual and a totem. So, what is a totem? Totem is an object which could be animal or a plant that serve as an emblem or a symbol of a kinship group or a person. Right? So, totemism is always associated with marriage regulation. In some society, totems are associated with a clan, but in some society, it is not among the Eskimos. There are 8 totemic exogamous clans among the Dalki Kharia. Totemism is usually a group institution, so the group may not be invariably be based on a millennial descent. In some societies, groups are named after a totemic species, like crocodile. There may be a mystical belief that member of each totem clan are descended from totemic species associated with it. Their belief is popular in Melanesia but rare among the African tribes. Right? Then importance of function performed by totem differ with regard to different society. In the some social functions could be more important while religious function may assume in prominence in others. So they then A.P. Elkin defined various kind of totemism. Individual totems are associated with individual. Moiety totem is associated with specific moieties. And totem should be also be a section or a subsection. Clan totemism, sex totem, local totemism or totemism of territorial groups. Group totemism is mostly widely disseminated from a form of totem. So, social totem is associated with the human relation and marriage, and cultural totem is concerned with the mythology, rituals and sacred aspects of tribal life. Right? So, this is all about totem. Then after that, the first explanation of totemism was put forward by a John McLennan. He never discussed the specific origin of totemism but sought to indicate that all human races in ancient time had passed through totemistic stage. He viewed work criticized by E.B. Tyler, who rejected the confusion of totemism with the mere worship of animals and plants. He regarded totemism as being a part of animism. The people believe that anima, after leaving the body, maintain the presence over a plant and animal. However, he was forced to view totem and the basis of a religion. Then James Fraser offered 3 theories: outward soul theory, cooperative magic theory, and conception theory. The first theory relates to belief of primitive man that human souls must be hidden from attack by nefarious powers. The belief and practices were shielding the human soul in animals, plants, and other species for preservation and safety. Belief enhanced the religious status of the animal or a plant, but it was not known in which particular animal of the species or the soul has taken its abode. The custom in time leads to veneration of the entire species. In the second theory, Fraser traced the origin of totemism to certain ceremony where the group arrived the idea that it should start the worship of a particular animal or a plant mainly for its multiplication. The group at same time imposed a prohibition in eating it. The belief had its origin in cooperation between different groups, as a result of which group became interdependent. Then third theory, spirit living in animals and plants, responsible for impregnating the woman, that's why plants and animals are viewed with a reverence. Fraser says that totem has its origin in certain beliefs. In fact, all those beliefs propounded by the evolutionist have been termed by Ivan Pichard if I were a horse theory. Right? Then after that, Durkheim explained totemism from a sociological point of view. He analyzed the origin of religion in terms of totemism. For Durkheim, the sphere of sacred is a reflection of emotion that underlies social activity. Totem was a reflection of group consciousness based on the conception of impersonal power. The collective consciousness is manifested through identification of individual of a group with an animal or a plant species. Collective act of worshipping the totem reinforces group solidarity. And after that, Malinowski offered the first functional theory called the utilitarian theory. In essence, the theory says that totems are object of reverence because they provide food to eat. In other words, totems are utility. Totems are worshipped because they provide subsistence. So he explained according to the functional point of view, right? So this is all about totems. Then after that, taboos. The word taboo was introduced by a Captain James Cook, implying a negative sanction. Cook says that Melanesians use term taboo in context of mana, which can enter any object to protect the mana, in general called taboo. Taboo always have a supernatural or magical sanction behind it. In fact, taboos is also unwritten law of savage societies. In simple societies, they unwritten laws are the taboos, which have to follow by the every individual of that particular society, right? So Durkheim used the idea of prohibition in his idea of religion, said that sacred and profane entities are separated by certain interdiction. It is because of the venerability of a sacred that it should be protected. The aim of the taboo appear to be limit the individual to norms of his society. Therefore, this society which is widely affected by the observance or non-observance of taboo, but the initiative always rests to certain extent with the individual. Anthropologists make a distinction between three kind of taboo. In incest taboo, prohibition is imposed on a sexual relation between the primary kin. Aim of such prohibition is to be regulate sex in a society. If today we have a notion of society, it is primarily because of the incest taboo. In ritual taboo, prohibition is important ritual concerned with sacred if the taboos are not observed. And after that, there is a third taboo, that is rank taboo, is associated with the Melanesian society where king was separated from the commoner. Right? And after that, status specific taboos are those which are applicable to men and women and can be contrasted with universal taboo. So incest taboo is the example of the universal taboo. Radcliffe Brown extended the Durkheim's idea that sacred and profane entities are separated by taboo. Sacred entities are protected and they are vulnerable to pollution because of solidarity emerges from worship of the sacred object. He says that taboo is a religious action and contribute to social solidarity. In order to prevent the danger of disrupting solidarity, people resort to taboo's action. So this is all about taboo, right?